And you say they made it after you placed the Moonstone?
Do you know why, or what it means? Does it have to do with the Snidgets?
The breadth of one... be as wide as the seas, and yet only run so deep.
It's good to see you again, Doran. Did Poppy tell you about everything that's happened?
She did, and I am glad to see that you are both safely returned. I did question the wisdom of sending you on a path at a time when that path was unknown at best, deadly at worst. But the acumen of the centaurs is neither personal nor partial. The skies tell us what is to come, and often we do not know what we have seen until it has come to pass.
You knew the poachers would try to kill Poppy and me.
I did not know, my young friend. But I shall say that I was not surprised. It was in much the same manner that I expected our first meeting.
I don't suppose you'd like to start from the beginning. I think Poppy and I could use that.
Of course. I find it is often the best place to start, is it not? Many, many moons ago, I divined a series of events. Their meaning long evaded me, until you brought news of the Snidgets and their poacher pursuers. I believe the symbol created by the Mooncalves dance marks the place the Snidgets are hidden. And serendipitously, I believe that I know the very place.
Please, go on.
I have seen that symbol only once, on a rock face in the cliffs of the forest. You should make haste there. The Snidgets that have been kept there for so many years may no longer be safe.
If you're right about this place, then we should make our way there.
I shall see you there. We cannot afford to lose the Snidgets once again.
Riverboro. Always a lovely place to visit. Give my best to Ida.
How remarkable. I got here as soon as I could.
Did you see the symbol above the entrance? It's the one the Mooncalfs made at the henge. Of course Doran implied as much, but to see it up there...
Could this actually be where the Snidgets are hidden?
Let's find out. Doran's waiting for us just up ahead.
I'm ready if you are.
Can you believe it? Actual Snidgets! I'm glad we seem to be a step ahead of the poachers.
It is a little strange we haven't heard anything from them.
If we're lucky, they're still poring over Gran's research. There was a fair amount. We, on the other hand, had Doran to guide us. Even if the poachers do somehow stumble upon this place, we shall be long gone.
Greetings.
I hope we haven't kept you waiting long, Doran.
Not at all. Then again, it is not I who awaits your arrival. Do you have the Moonstone with you?
We do.
Good. It is as important to what happens next as both of you are.
So, what does happen next? What are these killers here?
A safeguard, I suspect. There is only one way to find out. And as for how to go about that, the two of you may know better than anyone.
I wonder if the pillars move. Perhaps it has to do with the light and the darkness. Perhaps it has to do with the light and the darkness. Perhaps it has to do with the light and the darkness.
Accio.
Perhaps it has to do with the light and the darkness.
Yes.
Perhaps it has to do with the light and the darkness. It has to do with the light and the darkness.
Here.
Perhaps it has to do with the light in the darkness. A doorway.
I suspect we all know what lies beyond that passage. And now, I'm afraid I must leave you. At least for a time.
You're not coming in with us.
If the Snidgets are here, the herd will want to see the truth.
Look at the murals on the wall.
Kufringa creatures!
This place must have been built to protect them. They had nothing to fear.
What makes you say that?
The poacher camps always felt oppressive. It's hard to explain, but the feeling was palpable. At least to me. The sense I get here is of safety and calm. Quite the opposite of the poacher camps.
Whoever built this place certainly liked to read.
And the books are all about creatures.
Your gran would love it here.
She would. I can't wait to tell her all about it.
Kufringa!
I'll wager this isn't the dead end it seems to be.
Accio! Wingardium Leviosa! Accio! Wingardium Leviosa! Kufringa! Accio! Wingardium Leviosa! Wingardium Leviosa.
course. How clever.
Little puppy's waiting.
What was that?
More Darren. That's for certain.
Potato!
No!
Caprica!
You've made a mistake.
Well done.
Arrest them. Potato! Flipendringo!
Incendio!
Avoiding us. Ah! The lamb returns to the wolf.
Stupid one.
Ready your wands. The fight.
Back for more. Not the brightest child. Shall we finish what we've done? I've never felt I never expected that from you. Little pruning is it all. I'll make mulch.
I won't go down as easy.
You're putting me to sleep.
I think that is all of them.
Are the two of you unharmed? I had hoped to return before it was too late.
We're fine, but if you hadn't got here when you did... I led them here, Doran.
You fought with us against your kind. I am glad to have witnessed this. I now believe all that Doran told me.
They are the ones I saw, Elik.
Finish your work here, brother. All the events you divined have not yet come to pass.
There they are. Now, all that remains is to break the charm.
You want us to... I only ever wanted to see them safe, which they are. You should do it. But what happens now? They can't care for themselves, and surely once word gets out of their reappearance...
No harm will come to them. The centaurs will see to that. You have my word.
Thank you, Doran, for helping us to find them and to fight for them.
It is you who deserves the merit, child. You did what the poachers would never have. Remember that. You both fought bravely today. Allow us to carry the mantle from here.
If it's all right, Doran, I think I'd like to stay behind and spend a little more time with the Snidgets. Confringo!
This castle's hiding all sorts of secrets.
Accio! Confringo!
There's a victory that came none too soon. Ugh. only Professor Fig could have seen that.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind.
She's devastated. She just buried your uncle alone.
I did it for her.
Sebastian, Anne can't bear the thought of turning you in, but...
What? Turn me in? She saw what happened.
I'll give you some time to think, Sebastian.
Turn me in?
Sebastian.
Did you hear that? You saw what happened. I never wanted to hurt my uncle.
I know.
I can't believe he's gone. How did things go so wrong? I didn't mean it. I didn't mean to... Oh, Anne, I was only trying to help. I can't leave now. Anne needs me more than ever. You understand. You can talk to Ominous. Make him understand. He listens to you. I need to be with Anne.
Don't worry, Sebastian. I shall speak with Ominous.
Thank you. You're a good friend, truly.
No matter what happens from here, I'm glad we met.
Poor Sebastian.
Ominous.
What a mess. I can't believe it. After I last saw you, I went straight to Hogwarts. Before I had time to talk to Black, I heard from Anne. I rushed to Feldcroft and found her with Solomon's body. She was beside herself with grief. Part of her wants Sebastian to face the consequences, another part can't bear the thought of it. I don't want to lose Sebastian, but I don't think we have a choice.
We do have a choice. What good will it do to turn him in now? He clearly regrets everything. He's not going to do anything like this again.
We've both heard that before.
But we also need to think about Anne. She's lost her health, now she's lost her uncle. Do you really want to take her brother away from her too?
I understand what you're saying. Perhaps you're right. As much as I believe that Sebastian should pay for his actions, we'd only be punishing Anne as well. I hope we're doing the right thing. I'll talk to Anne. If it comes from me, she'll agree with this decision.
Thank you, Ominous. You're a good friend.
Whatever lies ahead, we must face it together. That I know.
I wondered if you might teach me how to cast a curse that you mentioned.
Oh, which one?
I'd like to learn how to cast the Killing Curse.
After all that's happened? Very well. You need to be precise with your wand movement. The incantation is Avada Kedavra. Are there any other curses you'd like to learn?
I'd like to learn how to cast the Killing Curse.
After all that's happened? Very well. You need to be precise with your wand movement. The incantation is Avada Kedavra. Are there any other curses you'd like to learn?
That's all I wanted to learn for now. Thank you.
Of course. You're the only one with whom I would entrust such knowledge. Let's speak again soon.
There's Ollivander's. I hope he can help me craft the Keeper's Wand. Hello, Mr. Ollivander. I wondered if you might be able to help me with something.
Good to see you, my young Ravenclaw friend. Allow me once again to express my family's gratitude. They were pleased to learn that the wand Richard Jackdaw disappeared with those many years ago had been located, even if it was somewhat unusable.
Glad to hear it.
Now, I received an owl from Eleazar, Professor Fig. He was a bit cryptic, said you need to have a special wand crafted, that you'd bring me the materials.
Yes, sir. I have them here.
Oh, my. How extraordinary. Remarkable design. I will be honest, I have never crafted a wand in this fashion. Repaired broken wands, of course, but this is something else entirely. Keeping me on my toes, aren't you? I think I can work with what you've brought me. Let me see what I can do. It is done. I should warn you, I've never seen a wand like this before. My suspicion, as Professor Fig implied in his letter, is that it serves a unique purpose. I doubt you shall find much use for it otherwise.
I understand. Thank you, sir.
I'm afraid you're on your own. I've ensured that we have a moment to ourselves. Oh, come, come. No need for such theatrics. In light of what Ranrok now knows, you must agree that our interests are aligned.
Our interests will never be aligned.
You would let goblins take what is rightfully ours? The final repository belongs to wizard kind. We would be fools not to work together. What's that you've got there? Might this sudden visit to the Wandmaker have something to do with our mutual pursuit?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
That repository is my birthright!
Charles Rookwood wouldn't have wanted you near it.
The arrogance. Should have known better than to try and reason with a child. I've always said, children should be seen and not heard.
afraid of...
Ha!
Another pitiful beast.
Quickly. Ah, how delightful.
I'm not down with you.
Rumors don't go down.
You can't hold up.
You come to the wrong place, child. Huh?
Expulso!
Confringo!
You will pay for your deeds. See your deeds.
Try not to make this too
quite conducive.
Expulso!
You're no match for me.
Death from above!
That's a test I can do.
What?
Flash of inspiration. Come on, you are afraid to fight back.
Expulso!
You've made a great...
Expulso! You're going to regret that.
You will
pay.
Might want to look up. You should have joined me.
Believe it. Rookwood's reign is finally over. I'll need to send an owl to Natty right away. For now, though, I need to get back to the map chamber and tell Fig what's happened. Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He would have killed me once he found the repository, if not before. I had no choice.
You're right. You had no choice. You did what you had to do. The wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials. To ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
Astonishing.
That must be the way to the repository.
We can only hope that we're not too late, and that we find nothing but a repository undisturbed beyond this door.
I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered. Let's go. If his loyalists are here, he cannot be far behind.
You and I have faced worse, Professor.
We must be getting closer.
Renrook!
About
to get down! Oh, no, Rosary! Someone!
More of you!
We need to press on. Ranrock must be here somewhere.
This drill stands between us and him. We need to move it.
I shall handle it. One moment. Let's go.
The other professors.
I see.
toy?
How childish!
It worked. Let's go.
Lumos!
Ranrok must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I fear you're right, Professor. There's nothing we can do but keep searching.
Lumos!
Listen. More goblins up ahead.
Not quiet. What happened?
Students and their professor.
Time for the bench.
Such arrogance. Cutting up the
monster. Rather
a wise coming back this way.
Was that your best?
Let's get it. Oh, that was meant for me.
Confringo.
Spells glance off of me.
I shall avenge your death.
These tunnels haven't brought us much luck.
We're getting closer, Professor. That way.
Have somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Stand of this way! We shall make quick work of them!
Oh. They got this.
How nice of you to
stop by. How nice of you to stop by.
You won't stop me.
Help me!
And will I fail?
I will.
Up for a bit of glory.
I'm relieved we got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I've decided to open the repository. Its power cannot lie dormant for centuries more.
After everything you've seen, what about Isadora's fate?
Isadora knew she had a remarkable power to help people. I intend to use my ability to finish her work, build upon it.
But this could go wrong in so many ways. You, of all wizard kind, are wholly aware of the potential cost.
I also know the promise, Professor. With all I have learned, I can avoid making the same mistakes Isadora did. I can learn to wield this magic for good.
The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you were two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either. There seems to be
you, Miriam. For everything.
Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig. Well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
Please meet me as soon as possible.
Can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered. I wish the same could have been done for my uncle. I wonder if there's a chance Anne would meet me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did. But it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait. What are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the Loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrok, Isadora's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrok. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her, and she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. Ominous said he's spoken with Anne. I wonder if she'll see me. I'll find out and send word when I know more. I've thought about what you told me in the Great Hall. I would like to speak with you. Meet me in the Undercroft as soon as you can.
What are you up to now?
Just the person I was hoping to see.
I see Doran finally convinced you to leave the Snidgets.
If anyone can keep them out of poacher hands, it's the Centaurs. And I wanted to thank you. When the poachers ambushed us, it was nice not to face them alone.
Of course. It's the sort of thing friends do for each other, isn't it?
I suppose so. I am glad you came to Hogwarts. It's already been my best year. I wouldn't want a repeat of Horntail Hall, of course, but I did enjoy the Three Broomsticks. Had no idea how lovely it was there.
Had you never been to the Three Broomsticks?
I used to spend most of my time with Highwing. And, well, I don't know how Serona feels about Hippogriffs popping in for a butterbeer. Highwing's the only one I would have gone with. Or Gran, of course.
Nothing wrong with that. Highwing's good company.
She is. Although I am beginning to see the appeal of, human friends. It was nice to talk about my parents and Gran with someone. And share Highwing.
I don't suppose you've heard anything from your parents, have you?
I haven't, but I'm perfectly fine with that.
Does your Gran know that we found the Snidgets?
I couldn't hold it in any longer. I told her everything. She was livid that I'd been anywhere near the poachers, but she confessed that she was rather envious about the Snidgets.
It has all been a pleasure, Poppy. Do try and stay out of trouble.
don't know that I can. We've taken on poachers twice now, successfully. I rather think you've helped me develop a taste for it. And with centaurs as allies, I might actually go looking for trouble. You and I should meet for a butter... Perhaps Hywin can join us?
I'm glad you came.
Sebastian, I received your L. What's happened?
Ominous spoke with Anne about what happened with my Uncle Solomon. She believes I should pay for what I did, but she won't turn me in. She said the guilt I'll have to live with is punishment enough.
I'm so sorry, but I'm glad to know that you can at least try to move on now.
The thing is, I think I've lost my sister, my twin, forever. She refuses to even see me. I can't blame her. I couldn't really blame any of you if you gave up on me entirely. You all believed in me, and I let you all down.
Sebastian, I'm afraid Anne may never be able to forgive you. But at least now you have a chance to change your path.
I am glad for that. But I still have hopes that Anne may in time understand what happened and come to forgive me. I realize I can't undo what's been done, but I can try every day to make up for it. I owe you and Ominous everything for standing by me.
Well, it wasn't easy. But I believe in you, Sebastian. I've had a sense about you since that first day in Defense Against the Dark Arts.
Seems so long ago. Thank you. I have no idea what's to come, but I'm grateful for your friendship. I'm glad you came to Hogwarts.
Are you ready to finish Harlow? Are you ready to finish Harlow?
I'm ready to finish Harlow once and for all. What is your plan?
I received an owl from Mrs. Bickle. She wondered if we were having any luck going after Harlow. Suggested we could gather evidence from a friend near Manor Cape.
But she warned us to stay out of it. Was rather adamant about it.
Precisely.
Harlow knows that we saved Archie, and that we rescued Mr. Rabe. The letter didn't come from Mrs. Bickle, did it?
I do not believe it did. Harlow intends to ambush us.
But now we have the upper hand. We can prepare.
We are stronger than Harlow, and he knows it. That's why he's resorting to this sort of trickery. We must go.
Agreed. Let's finish this.
Brilliant.
Perhaps we ought to inform Officer Singer about that.
I already sent her an owl to let her know that we were following a lead given to us by Mrs. Bickle.
Are you concerned she might tell your mother?
Indeed she will, but so be it. I am tired of hiding it from her. My mother needs to understand that I will not be safe from the Ashwinders until everyone is. I shall pursue them until they are finished, and I think she knows that. As do you.
That I do.
Keep an eye out. Harlow is likely around here somewhere. I sense he is close.
Where is he?
I do not know. We should look around.
I'll make you wish.
Animal children, walk right into our trap.
Explosive!
Damn you!
Incendio! I can do this all day.
Made a great mistake.
What?
Sionai, innit? And her excruciatingly loyal companion. You two have done quite a bit of damage to my business interests. But I must grudgingly give you some credit. What was once a mere annoyance has become remarkably problematic. Fortunately, I pride myself on my problem-solving skills.
Shame to see such potential go to waste.
Tickle!
Go now, you can do better than that. I've
managed to mug, man.
Yeah.
Crucio!
Nancy! No! Nancy!
What sort of world are we in where children solve our problems?
Depulsion!
Are you sure you are up for a visitor?
Yes, Mother. I feel fine, and it will do me good to see my friend.
Very well. But do not overdo it, Natsai.
I know, Mother. It is good to see you, my friend.
I'm glad to see you're doing so well.
I am doing better than it appears. I am only here because my mother insisted, just to be safe. I was relieved when she told me that you were all right.
Only because of you. How are you feeling?
Well, I've had better days, but Nurse Blaney says that I am on the mend.
I'm sorry, Natty. It's my fault you got hurt.
What? No! Do not blame yourself for this. The moment that I saw Harlow aim his wand at you, well...
You quickly made the choice to protect me.
I did what I had to, and I would do it again. I could not simply stand there and let you get hurt.
Then I shouldn't feel guilty?
Of course not. There was nothing that you... Oh! Oh my... I cannot believe that it took me this long to see it. He made a choice. Based on instinct, my father, you, my friend, are no more to blame for my injuries today than I am to blame for my father's sacrifice years ago.
From what I know of him, it seems there's a lot of your father in you.
That's very kind of you to say. I hope that you are right. This has all been a bit much, hasn't it? A battle here at Hogwarts. Everything we have done to take down Harlow and the rest of Rookwood's lot. But we have done it. Rookwood is dead, Harlow is on his way to Azkaban, and the rest of them are on the run. A few of the dregs will still be about, fighting for their lost cause. But Rookwood's enterprise has fallen apart.
Everything is safer now because of us. Because of you.
Thank you, but we make a formidable team. You, my fellow traveler, have enriched my time at Hogwarts beyond anything I could have imagined. Thank you. I believe your friendship to be one of the most important in my life. Thank you for coming to visit me. It is always good to see you.
Revelio.
Velio. Aloha Mora. Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Revelio. Alohomora. Confringo! Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Thank you. Revelio. Alohomora.
Why do students always run when Peavesy wants to have some fun?
Revelio. Alohomora. Mind now, demiguys. Revelio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora.
It looks as if the sapling uprooted the mighty oak. In this metaphor, you are the sapling, and Gladrock is the oak.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
Last week, I performed a knee reversal.
Revelio.
Well,
broomsticks are so out of date. Revelio.
I haven't been called Puffskeen Dunking once since you brought me that venomous tentacular leaf.
Revelio.
It's me, Gareth. Revelio. Do you have a moment?
Accio. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Revelio.
Avelio. What do we have here? A demiguise. Mind now, demiguys. Revelio. 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 Revelio.
We beg silence of you.
Revelio.
Moment of your silence.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
Marvelous! Simply marvelous!
I've never seen the headmaster so regal.
Actually, I have come to think of it. His way, really, isn't it?
Scrope's master is indeed regal, sir.
You wouldn't mind. Sweep the mine, would you?
Scrope may only carry out the request.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. Nice to see you, my young friend. What if he sticks like this?
What? Don't be silly.
Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me?
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on, and that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the wizarding world is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a graphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs, even helped Mr. Ollivander track down a family wand.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. I'm just glad you found such a good friend in Miss Sweeting. It's nice to see her engaging more with her classmates. There have evidently been Snidget sightings in the area lately. If the centaurs are to be believed, two Hogwarts students are behind it.
I'm certain I don't know what...
No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course. What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. It seems you've completed much of your field guide. Well done. But you've still a little left to do. Fortunately, you do have some time to prepare for your OWLs. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor, for everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us.
Revelio. Velio.
This year, we have seen our students exemplify the bravery of Godric Gryffindor.
Yeah!
Allow me to finish.
Woo-hoo!
The loyalty Woo-hoo! Of Helga Hufflepuff. The wisdom of Rowena Ravenclaw.
Hey!
And the ambition of Salazar Slytherin. And so, the winner of this year's House Cup...
Excuse me, Headmaster, if I may. One particular student's heroism during the attack on Hogwarts, not to mention the level to which they have excelled in their coursework, as a new student, no less. Well, it would seem that it certainly merits... I'd say 100 points to their house. Wouldn't you agree?
Ah, yes. Thank you, Professor Weasley. I suppose we have our winner.
Revelio.
Never been prouder than for how you handled Ranrok.
Professor, do you have a moment?
I do. What is it?
I wondered, did you attend Hogwarts?
I did. I am a proud member of Ravenclaw House, like you. Why do you ask?
I was curious as to how Hogwarts has changed over the years.
I see. Well, the castle itself, as I'm sure you have surmised, is full of surprises. I dare say more than the staircases change around here. As for the students, well, they seem to get more capable every year. Although, we got up to just as much mischief in my day as you seem to now. I used to look the other way at all sorts of roguery when I was head girl. I can tell you, however, that I did once admonish a certain Phineas Nigellus Black for enjoying a sugar quill during a lecture.
I hadn't realized that you and Professor Black were, students here together.
Appearances can be deceiving. You see, I was once wounded by time itself.
I'm not sure what that means, but it sounds horrible.
Ah, well, it was the risk I took with my prior position. You may or may not have heard that I was an unspeakable at the Ministry for years.
An unspeakable? What does...
As you might suspect, I cannot speak about what we did. Suffice it to say, the job was not without its hazards. I hope I've satisfied your curiosity for the moment.
You have. Thank you for speaking with me, Professor.
Keep up with your wand work. One must always be prepared for mischief, both inside and outside of the castle. Never been prouder than for how you handled Ranrok.
Wish I'd brought that owl to school. I don't understand. I adore my toad. At least somewhat.
the Ministry will hear about this! The fiends will rot in Azkaban!
Revelio. Revelio. That's it. I'm making good progress with these tokens. This Dedalian Keys challenge is coming along nicely. Another house token for the house chest. That's it. I'm making good progress with these tokens. Here we go, the last house token. Time to see what's inside. Headmistress, you praxy 'em all.
Wow, you turned out to be something of a hero, didn't you?
Hello, Nelly. Actually, I've found all of the keys and opened my house chest.
Oh, wonderful. What did you find?
I found a rather interesting costume.
Brilliant. Whew. Well, thank you for solving that mystery for me. I always wondered what those keys would lead to.